I'm Vicki Proctor. I'm the outdoor program team leader here in sunny Ohio. I work for Girl Scouts of Western Ohio. And what we're going to do today, actually I'm not, I'm going to introduce a volunteer, Sandy Skin, from Beaver Creek, Ohio. And she's gonna talk to you about box ovens. So she's gonna talk about how to make them and give you a few ideas of some things that you can cook in them. So the items that you need is you need a box. So, you know, almost like a paper size box, something, but the box needs a lid. And you can take the lid off and put the lid on. So you need the box, you need some aluminum foil, and then you need some tape. And you can use just duct tape or any kind of tape, but there is also a tape that you can get that is fireproof, it won't burn. But that's good to use inside. So I'm gonna let Sandy take it away and she'll tell you all about making a box oven.
Okay, I just cut off a small piece of foil here so that I could demonstrate how you attach it. Normally you would cut off a piece that would go totally around, under, and back around and down into the box. So you're gonna go like this. You're going to press it down inside, like so. And I'm gonna tape, and I'm only gonna tape one edge, but normally you would tape it on both edges. Bring it up here, bring it over here. And again, I'm going to tape it down on this side. But ideally you want this to be able to just go right around, just like you were wrapping a package. And then on the inside, I mentioned you should reinforce the corners. So by doing that, you would run a piece all the way down here from the bottom up and reinforce the corners like this, because all the cardboard must be covered. Okay, now I'm gonna show you one that's completed. If you notice, there's a hole on each end. There's a hole on this end too. I've reinforced this with aluminum tape on the corners and on the bottoms. And then the other thing you're gonna do is if you buy these, they sometimes come with lids, and you're just gonna set this in the bottom of the box. It just provides some additional protection so that the box does not get too hot, because as these get hot, they get brittle if you use them multiple times. Now this is where you're gonna put your charcoal, and basically at camp we have the regular shovels, and a shovel full of that will work well in here. And charcoal is better to use primarily because it retains the heat better, so there's an advantage to that. And then on this one, you make little quick things. You would spray the tray, and then you can put your little hors d'oeuvres in here. And you could sprinkle cheese on these, or you could sprinkle bacon bits, anything that, you know, will cook in a fairly quick time, or anything that, like, cheese just has to melt. And then you have to put your little rack in there, and that's because you don't want to cook right on top of the coals, because you might burn all your food. And then you put your tray with your food in here, and then you put the lid on like so, and you're good to go. And one of the biggest advantage of this is that it works really well as long as it's probably 60-65 degrees above. And it's great for little appetizers. I mean, things that you could put in there, and you melt the cheese, they take maybe about 5 or 10 minutes. And you can use corn chips, potato chips, anything like that, add cheese to them or add whatever you want. And I'm glad that you are watching, and hope that you enjoy it, and hope you make use of it. Thank you.
So now you know how to make a box oven, and they're really neat. So just a couple questions to wrap up. What did you enjoy the most about learning about box ovens? And also, was there anything difficult that you found while, you know, you made your box oven? Another question would be, what kind of hazards? You know, I'm always into the safety part, but what do you think the hazards are of, you know, maybe not necessarily making the box oven, but when you're cooking in it? I can think of one right away, because I think it's happened to all of us. And then the last question I would have is, now that you know how it works and how to make it, what would you cook in it? You know, would you do some hors d'oeuvre kind of things, or what kind of main main entrees would you cook in this? So just a great method for cooking, and hope you enjoyed it. Go out and have a great time with it.